Hi, Henry here from Tech Advisor, and we have Samsung's Galaxy S10 and S10 Plus. They're quite different looking phones, so in this video, we're going to have a look at how they compare to the Galaxy S9. Just before we compare them, what is new about the two phones? So first of all, you get a bigger screen size. The standard S10 is bigger now, and even bigger is the S10 Plus. They also have, as Samsung didn't even comment on in our presentation, hole punch cameras. Now that's probably a good thing. It depends how you feel about how it moves the icons across the screen, but you get bigger screens and it's a mad 93.1% screen to body ratio. On the back, three cameras on each one. There's also a S10e which has two cameras, but these two flagships both have three on the back. You just get the extra two on the front of the S10 Plus compared to the S10. The other most noticeable thing is the updated software. Samsung's One UI comes installed on the S10 and updates the look for 2019. So that's how they look. How does it look against the old one? If you thought the Galaxy S9 had small bezels, here's the Galaxy S10. It somehow manages to make the S9 look a bit dated. So Samsung's squeezed the bezel at the top there, but obviously instead of having the camera in the bezel, you've got it as a hole punch there. In the hand, they feel practically the same size. The S10 is a whisker taller, but similarly wide. And you're getting an even bigger screen there, as you can definitely see. On the back, aside from the fact that the S10 is still a bit of a fingerprint magnet, you've got three times the cameras, which is a great upgrade if you are into the smaller phone. One with a variable aperture on the S9 and a fingerprint sensor there, and you'll notice no fingerprint sensor on the S10 with its triple cameras. That is now what Samsung calls an ultrasonic fingerprint sensor, and while I can't show you, it's there in the screen. Here we have the S9 Plus and the S10 Plus. Again, quite a big change when you put them side by side. That extra room at the top of the screen is very noticeable, but what I will point out are how the icons have to move over because of the double cameras you get on the Plus. So if that's the sort of thing you're going to be picky about, you might want to think about whether this is the one for you. Dual cameras on the S9 with the fingerprint sensor updated to three cameras on the back, fingerprint sensor again in the screen. We'll have to wait until the full review, but Samsung says that the ultrasonic nature of it means it's going to work in the rain and in the cold, something that phones like the Mate 20 Pro and OnePlus 6T sure to struggle with. S10 comes pre-installed with Samsung's updated Android 9 Pie software, which is called One UI. It looks quite a lot different to the previous version that we have installed on the S9 on the left here. Icons are updated, the interface is a whole lot slicker on the S10. Let's take a look at the cameras, because again, they're upgraded here. So on the S9, the regular one, no zoom, even though you did have a pretty decent camera. On the S10, the camera app is again updated. You now have options down the bottom rather than at the top, which is handy for one-handed use. And the thing we've been impressed with so far with the S10 is the wide and ultra wide that you get. So the single lens is already pretty wide. Roll it back and you get a wide angle shot there. First time on a Samsung phone that you have an ultra wide. And zooming in, you also have 2x zoom thanks to that third camera. Impressive on a phone so thin. Things that the S10 retains from the S9, again, you'll be pleased to see a headphone jack on the bottom. USB-C obviously as well, but as many phones lose it, it's good to see Samsung still has it. You've also got right at the top there, the speaker grill. So on the S10 and S10 Plus, you still have dual speakers for stereo sound. So if you're into your specs, the S9 Plus wasn't exactly a stripped down phone, but this version of the S10 Plus, which comes in ceramic black or the ceramic white we have here, has up to a mad 1 terabyte of internal storage. So that's twice as much as you had on the Note 9. And it also has 12 gigabytes of RAM. Not needed on a phone, to be honest, but we've seen it from OnePlus with their 10 gig ST, like this will see you through a good 2 or 3 years without slowing down, we hope. Samsung's got a lot better at refining its software in recent years. Battery life should be improved as well, thanks to the new tech, new software on there as well, because you've got 9 Pi. The S10 and the S10 Plus can also wirelessly charge, albeit slowly, other wireless chargeable devices. So turn it upside down and you can charge another phone or the new Galaxy Buds, for example. With the S9, the most common color was the midnight black. It also came in a purple and in a blue as well, but in comparison, this is a lot more a stark phone. You've got a sort of pearlescent white on the S10 Plus here and a rose gold finish on the band. So dare we say it, sorry Samsung, a bit like Huawei. They have jazzed up your color options for this year. And again, this is a slightly more reserved regular S10, but that gray on the back is a nice kind of metallic and is a little bit more fancy and future thinking than the regular black S9. So the one thing we don't know at the moment is price, but as you can tell by the two phones I hold in my hand, this one is going to cost more. The S9 started at just over £700, but we're suspecting that the S10 is going to push the £800 to £1,000 mark, particularly when you're talking about the spec'd out S10. However, putting them side by side, you can see that Samsung, after the S8 and S9 that were very similar, but reinvented what phones can look like, they've kind of done it again with the S10. It just depends whether or not you like that hole punch and how much money you've got in your bank account.